Hey guys, what's up? Hope so you all are doing well and watching my videos. If you are doing so, please consider to subscribe and like my new channel. And let's begin today's video. So what are we doing in today's video? So what we're going to be doing is you're going to be actually discussing why should we use an IDE or IDEs. If you are a Python developer or you're getting so many projects, so long projects where you have to write thousands of lines of code. So, let's start this video. So, first question is why should you use an IDE if you are a Python developer or you are getting so many projects? Or long projects. So I will start with I'm gonna also give you some evidences that how am I right, okay, over here on Google. Okay, what am I saying is you can see over here, and I already searched it up for you. Now let's discuss it. So what does an IDE stand for? First of all, it stands for Integrated Development Environments, okay? And the first question is not related to why it's good, but it's related to why you should not use it or why is it bad. So I would say over here, as you can see, this says that it makes you lazy with the language. Now most of you got what I'm trying to say, or what I'm actually trying to say, okay? So what if you didn't get it? That means is if you take it in a bad way, it would be like it's gonna make you a lazy coder, okay? And I really don't want you to be a lazy coder, of course. But what it does is actually gives you, for example, if I'm doing Python and if I type P, okay, it's gonna give me an option by saying print. Not only print, it's also gonna give me parentheses, okay? And that's really helpful if you're writing a code and you don't want to write every single thing. You just write one word, and it's gonna generate the code for you, and you can just press enter, and it's gonna generate it for you. That's why it says over here that it makes you lazy with the language. Okay. Now the second thing which I really really love about an IDE, because I use an IDE myself for Python, and it's actually known as PyCharm, okay? And PyCharm is actually a really great IDE, a very intelligent IDE to use if you are a Python developer, or if you are, I don't know, if you're getting more projects in Python, Java, or any programming language, okay? It's actually great because, okay, one of the things which I love is sometimes I make mistakes in spelling. So I'm really bad at spelling, that means, okay? And for example, if I just want to spell paper, okay? And if I just make a very stupid mistake, which is I would type P-A-P-E-R, okay? Usually it's P-A-P-E-R, but if I would just type P-A-P-E-R, okay? What's gonna do is it's actually gonna give me a green line underneath the text which I have written. And that's where I'm going to be reviewing my code again, and which is really good. If you wrote your code once and you review it again, that is there any mistakes, that's really good, because then you're going to be sure that yes, there are no mistakes. Okay, and I would be like, oh, why is there a green mark underneath my word? Okay, and if I would just hover on it, it's going to tell me that it's because you have misspelled it, okay? And I'm also gonna put some pictures up if I can, if I would edit this video, and you're gonna know that how it works, and it's actually very great, okay? It's an amazing thing on an IDE, okay? And if you want to download an IDE, for example, a PyCharm, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you now, step by step, look, I'm not only discussing about IDEs, I'm also telling you about IDEs. I'm not only just discussing about an IDE, why you should use it, I'm also telling you how to download it. And don't think that, like, if you just search up download IDE and you're going to download it and you're going to run it. No, you have to use more than one thing. For example, I'm going to show you now. So if I would search download by charm, oops, and if I just press enter over here, if I click over here, okay, wait for it, okay, it's taking a bit long, okay, now, there are two versions of it, okay, if you're using macOS, you can just download it over here. If you're using a Linux, you can download it over here, which is a great thing about PyCharm. Now, if you want a professional one, it has a free trial, okay? It has a free trial, and then you have to pay for it, okay? And if you don't want to pay, you want to use it for free. Now, I would say just use the community version, because that's what I'm using, because they both are the same. They both have the same function, they both do the same things, okay? And community is free, okay? Community version, and over here, it says for pure Python development, okay? And over here, professional is for both scientific and web Python development with HTML, JavaScript, and SQL support. Now, if you want to buy the professional one, I don't, you know, it's your choice, you can. But if you want to just do Python on it, you can just download it over here, the community version. They both do the same job. Don't think that it's going to have, the professional version going to have more options for Python and the community isn't. They both have the same options, okay? Now, once you have downloaded it, I want you to search up download Python, okay? And over here, go on this website. I'm going to put both of the links in the description box, so you can quickly go and then follow the video, okay? Now, why are we downloading Python, okay? Now, right now, we are not doing Python, okay? I'm just telling you, I'm just warning you, because then you're going to be like, why are you not teaching us Python? Why not via JavaScript, okay? Because I told you in the last video, we're going to do JavaScript. But I thought this video is important for the people who are Python developers, or the people who want to know about IDEs. Okay, now if you're a Python developer, you know about this, okay, or if you're going to learn about it. Once you have downloaded PyCharm, you have to download this, okay? It's going to be the latest version of Python, okay? And once you have installed it, just go and run it. Because why do you need, first of all, this? It's because you need this Python, otherwise the Python isn't going to run for you, okay? So yes, that's pretty much it for today's video. Hopefully you learned something, and if you did, please consider to subscribe and like my channel. It really encourages me to create more content for you guys, just like this one. So I'm going to see you in my next video. Till then, bye-bye.